Hello, Aries. Welcome to your weekly forecast. This is your reading for the week ahead, May 23rd through the 29th, 2022. For all Aries suns, moons, risings, Aries on the house cusp, if you have your sun in the first house or Venus in Aries, you can watch this reading. Guys, I do have a new setup today. I did kind of clear out the old energy and I was getting tired of my like Halloween theme going on. So we're going into the summer and I'm a Leo, so I'm just feeling like ready for a change and how things look around here. So hopefully you guys like the new setup, and I'm probably going to be doing the rest of the weekly readings this way going forward with the top-down view. So anyway, Aries, welcome to your weekly forecast. For your reading today, we are using the Thelema Tarot deck here by Lo Scarabeo. If you want more information, you can visit www.loscarabeo.com or Facebook at Lo Scarabeo Tarot. I'll also list the decks down below in the description in case you're interested. We're going to be clarifying core cards today with the Vera, Sibilla, Italiana, also known as the Everyday Oracle, and this is also a deck by Lo Scarabeo, Torino, Italy. Oracle messages, we'll be using this Oracle of Shadows and Light by Lucy Cavendish, artwork by Jasmine Beckett Griffith, and the publisher here, I do not know. There's this little QR code on the back here. If you want to take a screenshot of that, that may help someone out there, because I believe I got that deck off Wish. So Aries, let's see what's going on with you over the next week. Please do keep in mind these are general forecasts and they may not resonate with everyone out there. As I always say, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please do come get a personal private tarot reading from either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. Spirit, give me six cards for Aries week ahead. What do they need to know? May 23rd through the 29th, all Aries that may be watching. Aries suns, moons, risings. Aries on the house cusp. Those with their sun in the first house. Venus and Aries. Give me six cards for the week ahead, Spirit. Like, share, comment, and subscribe, guys. If you aren't already subscribed to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button right now. Click all notifications so you'll always be notified whenever I do upload your weekly forecasts. And if you'd like to book a personal private tarot reading with me, my information is down below in the description box or up in the right-hand corner. Just click the eye in the sky. Underneath the deck, we do have the Empress in reverse, Venus. You could be dealing with a Taurus or a Libra this week. This is the underlying theme or challenge of this weekly forecast. Someone here could be having fertility issues. Someone here could be in poor health. Someone here could be mean, possessive, jealous, or smothering. Yeah, with the Ace of Cups in reverse, someone is feeling unloved here or depressed. So this could be you or someone you're dealing with. I do get a mother figure here. If someone is pregnant, someone could be having a difficult pregnancy. Okay, someone could have had a miscarriage here, or someone might be on their moon cycle. Okay, so there could be some aggression as well, or possibly someone here could be ill-tempered or just in a bad mood, feeling under the weather. Aries, how do you see yourself today? Let's see. We have the Three of Swords, Libra. So you're feeling heartbroken. Someone has broken your heart, Aries. This could be due to a painful love triangle. Some of you are experiencing a loss right now. I do feel like this could be connected to someone's pregnancy here. Someone may have had a miscarriage, or someone may have lost their child. What is the theme for your week ahead? We have the Hermit in reverse, Virgo. Well, you could be dealing with a Virgo this week. This is Major Arcana. Someone here is lost or lonely or doesn't want to be found. I'm getting someone here is looking for someone that can't be found, or someone is ghosting a situation here. I'm hearing this is the baby's, this could be the baby's father here. Someone here could be looking for the baby's father, or someone here could be looking for someone that can't be found. For example, someone has ghosted a situation. I also get something about a private investigator. You could be looking for someone here. Someone may have lost, a relative, a child. Someone here has gone missing. What is something you learned in your past, Aries? The strength in reverse. Leo's energy is here. A lesson you learned in your past that will be useful for you to remember this week. This was a lesson regarding abuse. Possibly here, issues with dominance and submission. Someone is very controlling. Someone here lost their temper, or someone here is aggressive, mean. This could also indicate power struggles, dominance and submission. Someone here has ugly hatred for someone else. This could also indicate compulsive behavior. For example, strong arming a situation, or just weakness or low self-esteem. You would have learned a lesson regarding this energy in your past. It's coming up again for you this week, not to forget. In the reverse position, someone here lacks integrity. In the reverse position, someone here is feeling weak or submissive. What is your challenge this week? We have the Eight of Cups in reverse, Scorpio. Your challenge is to walk away from a situation for once and for all. This is a situation that's not bringing you happiness. This is a situation that isn't bringing you satisfaction. It is going to be a challenge. Someone here is being challenged to walk away from a situation, but I'm guessing that's going to be very hard to do since the Eight of Cups is in reverse. Someone here keeps coming back to a situation even though it's not making them happy. So someone here is going in circles, it looks like. This could also be someone taking a walk. Someone is walking around in circles here, or someone does some sort of a loop here. This does relate to the Two of Cups, the soulmate energy. So you could be dealing with a soulmate this week that you are having a trouble walking away from. What is the lesson you're learning now? The Chariot, Cancer's energy. The lesson you're learning now is how to move forward despite how you're feeling. If you're feeling heartbroken, if someone has ghosted you or ghosted a situation, you're having trouble walking away, the lesson you're learning here is about determination. The lesson you're learning this week has to do with how to move forward and protect yourself and harness that shadow energy and that light energy to do everything in your willpower to move this. Oh, they didn't want me to say that. So someone may be preventing you from speaking up, Aries, or someone may not want you to speak up about something. Someone may be trying to silence you. Yeah, you need to move on from this person and fast. Whoever this is, I'm feeling like it's really hard for you to talk about whatever happened here, but you do need to move forward. You could also be learning a lesson regarding a Cancerian. What is the gift you will receive? We have the Eight of Wands reversed, Sagittarius. Okay. I'm going to have to clarify this card, actually, because how is this the gift Aries will receive? This is like a lot of sort of frenetic energy here. This is someone here that doesn't want to wait for the surprise. Someone here is rushing ahead before it's time. Someone here could be blocking someone on social media or blocking communication, or this is just one-way communication. How is this the gift for Aries? Why is the Eight of Wands reversed, the gift Aries will receive this week? Ooh, we have the Thief. We have the Costanza and the Domestico. Okay, so I do see a third party here. Someone here is going to... The gift you will receive is the Eight of Wands reversed. Someone here is rushing ahead too quickly. someone here thinks they're going to get away with something. It could be lost goods, robbery, or fraud. Someone here is a thief. This is like the Seven of Swords energy here. This person thinks that things are always going to stay the same, that they're always going to get away with it. This could be someone that works with a third party here. This could be someone that is trying to steal something from an employee, a helper, or a collaborator. I feel like someone's going to get blocked on social media, or someone is going to do something in a hurry and they're going to get caught. I'm literally seeing someone walking in the door just as someone is trying coming into the window. So someone is going to get caught lying, cheating, stealing here. Okay. Someone here is trying to knock over this pillar of perseverance, this immutability. This is something here that it's almost like someone's trying to take out your stability in a situation. I don't feel like they're going to be able to do that. I feel like someone's going to rush ahead too quickly, say something too quickly. They're not going to get away with this fraud. They're not going to get away with this robbery. They're not going to get away with any kind of lost goods here, because someone's going to, this could be an employee of yours or someone that is on your side. I also see someone coming in here and catching someone in the act, so to speak. So let's see, what is your advice this week, Aries? What is Aries' advice this week? This could also be someone getting caught cheating here. Someone could be caught cheating. Someone could walk in while someone is cheating, or someone could get found out here. Let's see. What is your advice for Aries this week, Spirit? May 23rd through the 29th. Advice for Aries, please. All Aries that may be watching. We have Witch at the End of the World, an important end, a new beginning. Yeah, someone's time is running out here. Okay. I'm getting there's no more ceilings to go here. There's no more. Whoever's doing this fraud, this thief, this stealing, whoever's being sneaky here, whoever's trying to get away with something, I feel like they're not going to get away with it anymore. There is an ending coming up this week, but there's also a new beginning. I feel like that new beginning is for you. I feel like the ending is for the other person here that's involved in whatever this is. At the bottom of the deck, we have Faceless Ghost and the Haunted Girl, ghost people. Yeah, we have the Hermit in reverse here, and that talks about someone who's a ghost or who's ghosting a situation. It could be a Virgo. I feel like someone here is very haunted. I feel like someone here, I'm seeing it like, at least two different people that are haunting this Virgo or haunting this person. I feel like they just, this is someone that is just going to be living in a nightmare, and they're never going to wake up from it, because they themselves, the only thing they can do is ghost a situation. But as soon as they ghost a situation, they become haunted by what they've done. So Aries, this is what I have for you this week. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys back next week. Take care.